You're looking live at Capitol Hill, where we are awaiting the start of the first hearing of the House Select Committee investigating the January 6th assault on the U.S. Capitol. Republicans have called the Select Committee a partisan sham, and Leader McCarthy pulled all of his Republican appointments out after Speaker Pelosi rejected two of them. Now Republican Congressman Jody Hice of Georgia joins me for a little bit more on this and his side of this story. Congressman, first of all, thanks for being here. We appreciate you taking the time. I know you voted to overturn the election results on January 6th, and you argued it was Trump supporters who lost their lives that day, not Trump supporters who were taking the lives of others. You said a Capitol police officer died that day of natural causes and voted against a bill awarding the Congressional Gold Medal to Capitol police officers. And now this morning you tweeted that Pelosi's January 6th sham show begins today. What an embarrassment. So walk me through this. Why do you think what's happening today, this hearing, is a sham?
Well, because it's one-sided. Look, this is Speaker Pelosi's entire committee. She elects the chairman. She selects the staff. She is now selecting who is going to come forth as witnesses. She has denied Republicans from being on the committee, individuals who are well qualified to do so. It shows very clearly that the cards are stacked. She wants this to be a one-sided select committee to go down a certain path of questioning and answers that, that go along with the narrative that she wants to create. The real question to me, Diane, is where was Nancy Pelosi in all of this? I mean, she oversees all the operational decisions of the House, no question. She has a part in all of this, and yet she refuses to testify. We need to hear from Nancy Pelosi. We need to hear from the Sergeant of Arms. We need to hear from the mayor of D.C. But as long as this committee is set up under the leadership, the direct leadership of Nancy Pelosi, none of those key players are going to ever give testimony, and that's just not right.
Now, after Nancy Pelosi rejected the two appointees from the Republican Party, House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy alluded to the idea that Republicans would launch their own investigation if she didn't reconsider. We now know she did not reconsider, but we haven't heard much more about that now Republican investigation. Do you expect that will go forward?
I think it will. It needs to. I mean, the American people, look, that was a horrible day. It was a tragic day for our country. We need answers. There's no question about that. But we're not going to get answers from this select committee. This is going to be a partisan thing through and through, and we're going to see that beginning today. So to counter that and to try to get to the truth, to try to get all the information, we need to have a further investigation. And as I said, some of those individuals that I mentioned a moment ago need to testify. We need answers. There's no question that there was intelligence days before January 6th that there was a potential riot that was going to take place. Where were those the individuals who were making the decisions? Why was the National Guard not called in even on the day of the riot? All of those answers ultimately are going to point to people like Nancy Pelosi.
All right. We'll see. Congressman Jody Hice of Georgia, I think one thing we can all agree on, the American people want all of the answers that we can possibly find on what happened that day and how to prevent it again. We appreciate your time today, Congressman. Thank you.
Thank you, Diane.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.